Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there.
Listen to us.
That's it.
Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up. So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, say what.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't let
them
do
it. No, go in. Don't
turn back.
A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. Stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua. It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where is she going? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zimbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
gonna help her.
Fight! Defend!
Take the torch and move.
She'll have to go under.
She has to. She has to.
The torch will come out.
Don't. The torch will come out.
She can do it.
She can't do it.
No. Oh. The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What was that?
Run.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
This place, it reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father said no one could see the monster in her.
Did I? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Sleeping beneath me.
The darkness is back.
We've lost him. Get to the light!
Without his head, you will never bring his soul back. His fate is sealed. Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zindo while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Stronger than him. Get them. Focus. Focus now. Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness. She wouldn't listen.
And now everybody is dead.
She should have known. She should have known.
Why doesn't she learn?
She learns.
Now the darkness has Dillian's.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search the truth.
She's let the darkness in.
Go, go, go.
The light's from us. She'll die.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find work. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
What's she doing?
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? She's going to get there.
Where is she going?
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop!
Stop letting me go.
Stop letting me go.
Follow you.
Quick.
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop!
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
But when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Lose it now. Come back to me.
not taking you from me.
I warn you, Senua. I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him.
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell. Come into my shadow.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Dillian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, Layla.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate to hate the darkness with a passion so great that you focus your mind on this quest. Time I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain to trust you. As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.